Minnesota Vikings fans, if you see the title of this video, do not overreact. It is simply stating what has gone on in the first couple of games with Kellen Mond under center, when he has played under center, and like the title suggests, it has been nothing short of disappointing. Now, is it entirely Kellen's fault, and will he be the worst third-round pick in the history of the Minnesota Vikings? No, absolutely not. But through the first two games in the preseason, it has been nothing short of disappointing. And last night, the drives went like this with Kellen under center. 3 plays, 7 yards. 3 plays, 1 yard. 3 plays, 1 yard. 3 plays, 4 yards. 6 plays, 30 yards. 3 plays, 19 yards, end of game. So Kellen hasn't exactly been killing it, but to be fair to him, the coaching staff and what Clint Kubiak has been dialing up hasn't exactly been fair either, and obviously along with that, Kellen has been playing with the twos, and he's not out there playing with Dalvin Cook, Justin Jefferson, and Adam Thielen. So again, to be fair to Kellen, the players that he's been playing with isn't what he would in an actual NFL game, but the results so far have been disappointing to say the least, as in Kellen's game so far, he has went a combined 12 for 28. With a total of 114 passing yards, which leads to 4 yards per passing attempt, which is bad to say the least. Now, in today's video, we are going to be breaking down everything with Kellen so far, so without further ado, let's dive right into the Kellen Mond preseason game breakdowns. So the first play that we are going to look at here was a 3rd and 12, and the reason why I have the receiver at the top, Wop Fillier, highlighted is because he comes across on a drag to about the 45-yard line, so 5 yards downfield, and is absolutely wide open. And what I would have liked to have seen Kellen done here instead of what he actually did was drop it off to Wop and see what he can do. And yes, by the way, this is Wop Fillier, the Twitter famous guy that is nicknamed Wop because of the Burger King Whoppers and how much he loves them. Anyways, what Kellen eventually does is he pulls it down for a 3-yard gain, but what the Colts were doing was letting anything underneath happen. So they were going to give Wop an easy 5 or even 7 yards, but they were going to have players there in that situation to tackle him before he gets to the sticks. So they would have been content giving up a 7 or 8 or even 10 yard gain, because in the preseason, more than likely, the Vikings on their own side of the ball, even in the regular season, would not have went for it on 4th down, and I would have liked to have seen Kellen give his guy at least a chance to fight for a 1st down, rather than him run for it, because Kellen, like Wop, would probably have not got the 1st down, and at this point, I really wouldn't have liked to see him force something down the field, 25 yards down the field, where it would have been a 2-on-1 situation in favor of the Colts. But this was just one thing where I would have liked to see Kellen at least get the ball out, rather than him run the ball for a measly 3 yards on 3rd and 12. Now, from one play I didn't particularly like from Kellen to one I really liked, this was arguably the best one of the night, other than one to Amir Smith-Marset for 25 yards, got called back for a holding penalty. But what Kellen does here that is especially good is it is 2nd and 8 late in the game. But what Kellen does especially good here is you'll see in this screenshot, look how hard all of the linebackers especially bite at this play action fake. And obviously Kellen at this point was beyond the play action, but every single linebacker bit hard, and then they're turning to the point where Kellen has their backs facing towards him, which only benefits him because he can place any ball right near them, and by the time that they would twist their head around to either try and locate the ball or try and pass break up a ball, they simply won't have the time because a 50 mile an hour pass from Kellen that's going to travel about 20 yards or 60 feet is going to be on them before they would have enough time to do that. So at this point, it would only benefit the Minnesota Vikings, as it would be either a defensive pass interference or, as we have here, Kellen drops a beautiful ball right in between the zone, and it was a big play, and it was the 2nd biggest play of the night aside from the play that we, as we said, got called back for a holding penalty. So this next play was obviously very late in the game, and it was the 3rd to final play of the evening for the Vikings. And what we have here is the Colts defenders 25 to 30 yards from the line of scrimmage, because the Vikings have to get roughly 50 yards to even be in field goal range. So Kellen is going to throw the ball here, and the ball is going to come out way late. And I really don't hold this too much against him because it is week 2 of the preseason of his rookie year. But you would like to see Kellen get the ball out a hair earlier, and again, this play was an incompletion. Initially, they ruled it an interception, but then they did come back and rule it incomplete. But this was a ball that Kellen was significantly late on, and had it been a starting caliber NFL player and not a player in the final 30 seconds of a preseason game, it probably would have been an interception. Of course, we've seen star players drop passes before, and of course, star defenders for that matter, but you would like to see Kellen get this ball out a hair earlier. I don't really hold it too much against him, though, given the situation that the Vikings were in, trying to win the game at this point in time. So this next play that we have here was the Amir Smith-Marset play that we discussed earlier that was called back for holding, and I figured we should at least show it because what Kellen does on this play is spectacular. Amir is running a deep drag across the middle of the screen, and Kellen drops the ball in between three Colts defenders, including over two linebackers' heads. And the reason why I really like this play from Kellen is he's throwing it to Amir Smith-Marset, who, by the way, can be a good receiver or at least a solid contributor and a good wide receiver 3 or 4 for the Minnesota Vikings in the future. But if Kellen is doing this with ISM, Amir Smith-Marset, then he can definitely do this with Adam Thielen, who would be perfect for this type of route, by the way, or Justin Jefferson, who, as we know, is a pretty good receiver in his own rights. This was a great play call by Clint Kubiak, despite me criticizing him earlier in the video, and a great execution by Kellen Mond, although unfortunately for Kellen and the rest of the Vikings, this was negated by a holding penalty, but this is the type of thing that you love to see for him, and for what he can build on in the future, is this type of play where he just drops it in a bucket to where Amir makes the play, and it is a big first down for the Vikings. So the final play that we will review in today's video was a simple 5-yard run by Kellen, but it is one thing that I love in his game that he is not afraid to do, and it is run the football. And obviously quarterbacks in today's generation that come out of college are more likely to run, as it's what they've grown up doing most of their lives, where you have older players like Tom Brady, for example, who obviously, as we know, does not run. But what Kellen does here is it's very good because there's nothing for him to throw to. So Kellen sees a hole open up in the line, and he takes what the defense gives him, and that is something that I'm sure Vikings coaches would love to see him do moving forward. If the situation prevails, and it is a time in the game where they're not down either 20 or need points now on the final drive like we saw with that play that he was really late on the read, this is exactly what good quarterbacks do at the NFL level. They will gladly take what the defense gives him, and obviously someone like Lamar is a lot better of an open field runner, and he can take a lot more than what Kellen can do in the running game for a quarterback position, but this type of thing to just, you know, gladly take the 1st and 10 to make it a 2nd and 5, have short yardage versus trying to force a pass, or at worst case throw the ball away. And this is something that is in Kellen's game that is not in Kirk's game, unless there is a blatant open side of the field where Kirk could run for 15 yards, because as we know, Kirk Cousins is not a scrambler. But I do love this in Kellen's game moving forward, and as we close today's video, what I would like to see moving forward is the Vikings either open up the playbook more and simply just clear it out. What Jake Browning does and what Kellen Mond does are completely different things, and by the way, with Jake Browning, I have been nothing short of completely disappointed in his playing style. He is way late on his reads in the first two games of the preseason, and at this point for the Vikings moving forward, obviously there is only one more preseason game, but I would absolutely love to just see Kellen play the entire second half with Kirk playing the entire first half. I think we know what we have in Jake Browning, which is not good, and I would love to see Kellen just open the playbook up, well, Clint Kubiak open the playbook up for Kellen, and just see what he can do in the entire second half versus these short under throws. And when he saw what he could do with that play action pass to Amir Smith-Marset, it was nothing short of spectacular. So anyways, despite Kellen having a not great start to the preseason, I did highlight some good plays today because I didn't want to just highlight all the bads, because he's averaged 4 yards per passing attempt, so we could go through all the incompletions or simply the checkdowns, and that would be a very boring video. So if you are still watching, I hope you enjoyed, and if you are, I ask at this time to please like the video and subscribe to the channel. It would mean the world and help the YouTube channel grow and help with the YouTube algorithm. So anyways, until next time, have a great day. Love you guys. Deuces. Peace. Skull.